Hey, all right, so let's get to the main topic here. We're going to go to the main topic. I saw this video a little while back about D.O. Hughley, and he posed a hell of a question, man, that made me think, man. It made me think. So
is
America
the way it
any
is.
Different today than it was in the 1970s, right? Right after civil rights, right? Let's see what D.O. Hughley got to say.
So I stumbled on a clip from a documentary called Bill Moyers Journal. It is Rosedale, the way it is. It is archive footage of people in New Jersey and Queens in the 1976 and 1978. The subject as then as now was race. At one point in the 78 clip, someone, a black family, had moved into a white neighborhood, and of course this is not Mississippi, this is not Arkansas, this is the Northeast, and it's popular to believe that these kind of things played out only in the South, but they did not. It was in the Northeast. And then there was another clip of young people in Queens chasing black people away, calling them niggas, spitting on them, kicking on them, and it brings me to where we are today, because it's called Rosedale the way it is. And I think that we would be remiss if we didn't talk about all the change that has been made, how America has evolved and how it has grown and how it has changed. And there's so many more nuances than there used to be. But one thing remains. When you look at the angry faces, the contorted faces of people calling you names and saying you don't belong here and saying some of the things you hear even right now, you wonder what happened to those kids that were chasing those black kids away. Now, those kids weren't ashamed. Those kids did it out loud. They called them niggas. They spit on them. They shouted at them. They derided them. And I imagine that since it was on, if there's a clip of it, somebody saw it somewhere. I guess their parents may have. I wonder what they were taught. I wonder, did they get were their parents angry with them? Did they chastise them? And I think it's ridiculous to believe that people can't change. We change all the time. We become different people based on our experiences, where we live, who we love. We grow. And I'd be remiss if I didn't talk about how some of those people can change. But I look at them and I wonder, did they all change? Because to change, you have to have something, some resonant thing, something that makes you think differently or act differently, some impetus for that change, some idea, some notion that has struck in you, and it becomes so overwhelming that it compels you to change. And I wonder what that moment was for them. I wonder, did they become different people? Did they teach their children different things? Did they have a different way of thinking? Change is good. I mean, I know that I change. I remember I used to feel that only people who lived in a certain neighborhood were worthy of my love, affection, and respect. I feel horrible about that. And I've worked the rest of my life to show that I've changed in that regard. I watched Rocky change when he beat Drago. If you can change and I can change, then we can all change. I've watched those things. Change is hard fought and it's resonant. But absent change, we stay the same. I saw those children and I wonder what happened to them. If they didn't change, did they become police officers or loan officers or teachers or lawyers or people who refused to hire or landlords who refused to rent? If they didn't change, did they teach their children the same thing? Did they teach them how to hate and how to spit and how to belittle? Did they become different people or did they become the same people they are now?
Pause it.
I defy you to look at that.
Did they become the same people that they are now? You damn right they did. Yep. They ain't gonna never change. God already told us that. You can't make something crooked or make something straight that he has made crooked.
Yep.
That's how they are. They won't change. They can mask it, but they won't change. You know, and this is what has happened. This is what it says, any difference. So we're gonna go over some stuff to see, has it changed, right? Or have they just masked it? That's the thing that we need to open our eyes to as a people, that it hasn't changed, that it's just been masked, right? Go to the next video. Let's show you. I'm going to show you some ways how it's been masked but not changed. Here's the video that he's talking about right here. The documentary, 1978, Rosedale, Queens, Up in the North. Play it.
Get out of
Mom.
And don't come back.
We were riding down this block, and these white people start saying, "Get out of here, niggas. You know, get out of my neighborhood. Don't come to this neighborhood." And then they start hitting on her.
Throwing rocks and everything else.
Throwing rocks. Because we were in their neighborhood.
We went on a bike hike to McDonald's. We didn't mean to bother anybody.
We had a nice
time. We saw a parade. We saw a gathering. So we went down there to see what was happening. All right. I mean, we didn't bother anybody. We weren't looking for trouble. I never even know people around here were like that. I've never experienced anything like this in my life.
What happened to you?
Nothing happened to me, but this little boy, short boy about his, my size, or little short, had picked up a rock, and he was in the front of all these tall hunkies. But he threw the rock. He tried to hit me, my sister, but he almost hit me about that much away from me. And I was sure I wish he had hit me with that rock. I would pick up the rock right next to me and hit him right dead in his face.
They always say niggas are doing everything. They always say we're doing everything, right? Every time the white people come down the block, we don't push them out their neighborhood and throw rocks and start hitting them.
We don't bother the white people around our neighborhood, but when we get in a white neighborhood, they just push us out.
Hey, yeah. Stop it. Stop everybody. It. Stop it, stop it, stop it, stop it.
This is 1970.
Yeah, this is 1970.
In the suburbs.
And like D.L. Hughley saying, right, in the suburbs. A lot of Negroes left the South running to the North thinking that
to leave
it was going to be better.
Yep.
Right.
But watch this, get Sirach chapter 12. Get Sirach chapter 12, verse 10. Because D.L. Hughley, he proposed a hell of a question.
He said, what happened to those
people?
And the thing is, them kids is about... At 1970, they about 10, 12 years old, right? Mm-hmm. So that would make them about 40, 50 years old
they
right
now. They still living right.
Right. The ripe old age to be a 10, 15-year-old, a 10, 15-year veteran cop, a 15-year veteran judge, right?
Yep, with kids.
Prosecutor.
Prosecutors.
There you go. With a family, with a wife and a husband, or you got children. You're teaching the children the same thing you were doing. Hey, read that. President.
Sirach chapter 12 and verse 10. Never trust thine enemy.
God says never trust your enemy. Your enemies are those that put you behind on slave ships and sold you on auction blocks. Those are your enemies. Read.
For like as iron rusteth, so is his wickedness.
Watch verse 11.
Though he humble himself.
That's what Cat was breaking out. They just taught them how to mask it. They didn't teach them how to completely stop hating.
Yep.
They just said, don't be openly hating. Yep. That's why everybody loves Donald Trump.
Yep.
Because Donald Trump openly is racist as hell.
He's speaking for them.
For them.
They are living through him because it's taking everything in them to mask the hatred that they got
for
Negroes, and he coming out saying it. Oh, we love you, Donald Trump.
Cap, I got a, I work, where I work at.
Yeah.
And one of the nurses, he's a white dude. Now this dude laughs and jokes with me every single day, all day. He calls me brother. How's you doing today, Gad?
Oh boy.
How you doing, brother? Everything's all right. One time, this old veteran came through. He got a hat on that says, "Make America Great Again," right? So the dude, as he's checking out, the nurse goes by and says, "Hey, brother, nice hat." In my mind, I said, you damn racist mother.
He humbles himself. He's been right next to you all that time.
Humbling himself.
Yeah. Right, right.
He masked it. Yeah. Read on.
Wait, just hold on. Just like this video right here, the man that's recording it is the same man that's asking these young babies what happened, who did this, and then the other. Well, why the hell you ain't step in and stop it?
Right. No.
He was recording the whole thing, all the N-words, and then he gonna come, what happened?
Right.
Right. You gotta understand, because Esau is constantly trying to gauge us. Okay, they angry now. This ain't the right time to do spread open up the trap. Yeah. So let's hold off. Let's wait a couple of more generations.
Right.
Let's release these ads to desensitize them. Our witchcraft not working. They still angry. Let's hold off.
Yep.
That's exactly what is going on.
Yeah, finish that. Finish verse 11.
though he humble himself and go crouching
and be and he give off the impression like he's equal to you. Mm-hmm. Read.
Yet take good heed.
Take what?
Take good heed.
The Lord said, beware. 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 Read on.
And beware of him.
Beware of him.
And thou shalt be unto him as if thou hast wiped a looking glass.
Read on. Watch this.
And thou shalt know that his rust hath not been altogether wiped away.
Their rust or their wickedness will never be wiped away.
Hey, it's because of this. Go to Ecclesiastes 7 and 13. It will never go away, just like you said, for this one reason. We keep looking on the outside, man. I'm telling you, you got to look past the flesh and the blood. You got to look deeper than that. Go ahead, read that.
Ecclesiastes chapter 11.
7 and 13.
Sorry. Chapter 7 and verse 13. Consider the work of God.
Consider. God made us. He made the Israelites, the black, Hispanics, Native. And God made the enemy. He made the Edomites, right? He made the Japanese. Consider the work of God. Read.
For who can make that straight which he hath made crooked?
How can you make that right which God has made wrong?
Right. And he said, in spirit. There's up is not a right.
There you
right.
go. That's the precept.
As soon as they be born, right.
they lying.
Right, they lie. They speak wickedness. As soon as they be born.
The, yeah. Consider the sun, the moons, and how powerful God is. And consider the people that he made.
Right.
God saying, who can make that straight which I have made crooked? You can't change them, so him. You better never trust them.
Never trust them.
No matter how much they humble themselves, right? So go to the next video. I'm going to show you something. We're going to show you something. We're going to show you how it ain't changed. They're just in the process of humbling themselves because they can make money off of you, right? Remember, that happened in the back in the neighborhood, right? Remember, that was overt, right? Overt racism. Let's see the covert. Let's see the humbling, the hiding that they have done. Hold on. Where you going? What you doing, man? I'm reading the article, not you. Damn. Go there. App developer responds to the racist next door, right? Go down. Okay. The company behind the widely used neighborhood networking app has responded to claims of rampant racial profiling and bigotry following the Roots examination of racism on the increasingly popular genre of neighborhood based social media, the Neighborhood Watch, right? You know how it used to be just an old lady peeking out the damn window?
Right.
And if you was walking down the street with your boys and you looked like a thug, they called the police on you?
Right.
There was an old lady, you didn't know what house she was, but you seen it on the pole, Neighborhood Watch here, so somebody's looking out the damn window mm-hmm. at me. Mm-hmm. So now they took it out the old lady hand because she done died off, right? So now they put it into an app. They put it into an app, right? So Nextdoor is used to connect residents in over 198,000 neighborhoods in the U.S. alone, according to the company's website. The app is the undisputed leader in a new subcategory of tech that allows users to create location-based miniature social media networks in their communities. After customers sign up for the service and verify their address, they become connected to a localized online community, right? Look at this. While apps like Nextdoor and Neighbors build themselves as a way to communicate with neighbors to borrow a ladder, find lost pets, or discuss road repairs, that's what it's meant for, right? That's right. What it's supposed to be.
Right.
Who got a ladder in my neighborhood, right? Mm-hmm. The Roots spoke with people in cities and towns across the country who shared stories of how they discovered that they were essentially surrounded by Barbecue Becky's. If you know anything about Barbecue Becky,
right,
that's the one that called the police on the black people in Oakland.
Right. For the smoke.
For the smoke. Uh-uh. You can't have charcoal here. Only electric on this land right here on this park property.
Right.
That's Barbecue Becky. Or Pool Patrol Paws. Or where they, you know, black kids in the pool, they pull a gun on you, make you get out of the pool. When it's free swimming if you live in the complex. But white people see a black kids in the pool, they pull a gun on them and make them get out. All right, it said readers shared troubling stories such as residents sending out a spook alert. This is what I'm talking about, how it used to be covert.
Right.
Now it's over.
Spook alert is nigga alert.
That's nigga alert. They used to run up on you, spit in your face, throw rocks at you, right? Now they got the app. Spook alert.
I'm over
here. Spook alert.
Everybody get your gun and go out. That's the same thing for Ring. Ring connects neighbors all around the neighborhood, and now they videotaping whoever walking through, and they don't say nothing when
Patriot Act. You can't do nothing about it. Right. So it says sending out a spook alert and calling the cops when a black woman visited her family's beach house. Another described a situation that involved an armed man riding through the neighborhood looking for a suspicious dark-skinned person. So the dude got his gun, saw it on the app. He said spook alert, got on his bike, got his gun, ran through the neighborhood looking for a dark-skinned person who was described in a next-door post. As a community-building platform, we explicitly prohibit racial profiling.
Come on, man. They know what they was getting into.
Right.
Come on.
And take this issue extraordinarily seriously. Next Door said in a statement to The Root, when we learned of incidents in Oakland, California in 2015, we consulted activists, academics, and experts in this field to determine the best approach to address the critical issue on the platform. Next Door said tweaks to its algorithm and community standards have resulted in 75% reduction in problematic posts, noting that less than 0.01% of all posts on Next Door are related to racial profiling. Now, when users post about crime and safety, the company requires persons reporting on someone to share more than just the suspect's person's race. So at first, all you had to do was type in
spook alert.
Are they black? Black spook alert. And that's all the white folks needed to see was in the house.
Yep.
Niggas are around here. Let's go hunt them down.
Yep.
That's exactly what they did in that Rosedale thing. It was covert then. Now it's overt. They do it through an app. And that thing ain't going to stop. They'll come up. Esau will come up with some more keywords to let you know if it's Negroes in our neighborhood. Get on the bikes. Let's hunt them down and run them out like we used to.
Same thing they did for Bob Marley's granddaughter. Same thing they did for Professor
Henry Louis Gates.
Henry Louis Gates at his own house.
Call the police on the dude, man. Go to the next article. Let's show you some more. Go to the next one. We're going to show you.
Blackface.
All right, run it back to show you how it ain't changed. Go ahead.
Blackface.
America is not new to scandals about blackface.
Minstrel shows, right? Blackface, where white actors dressed up, painted their face.
Blackface minstrelsy had tremendous power. And the whole idea of objectifying a person and taking away their humanity and reducing them to stereotypes and images and making fun of them is a painful experience for those people who are the subject of this kind of treatment.
These performances portray black people as lazy, stupid, hypersexual, and cowardly. Go ahead. The racist characters grew popular through the 19th century. They appeared in children's books, advertisements, movies.
Baby, I'm coming. Oh, God, I hope I'm not late.
Recent history. Go ahead.
That was Jimmy Kimmel.
Jimmy Kimmel.
Yep.
Jimmy Fallon. Ted Danson.
There you go.
And Megyn Kelly just recently defended it too.
So there was a controversy on The Real Housewives of New York with Luann as she dresses Diana Ross. And she made her skin look darker than it really is. And people said that that was racist. And I don't know, I thought, like, who doesn't love Diana Ross?
But even after America spent decades with this long history of racism, 2019, African American communities were forced to explain why blackface is controversial. Go ahead.
I think it's going to take some time to move past it.
How much time?
These are just isolated instances that we know on a wide public scale. This history and the prevalence of this history is widespread, and I think this is the perfect opportunity to engage in those dialogues that use blackface minstrelsy as an example of how race has functioned in this society and how it continues to curtail us for really treating each other fairly and responsibly and championing equality for all.
All right, so how long is it going to take? How long is it going to take to stop blackfacing back then and still now, right?
Right. Right.
We're
always talking about let's engage in dialogue.
Right. Y'all right. always
want
to talk.
They always want peace with the oppressor.
Talk. We've been talking forever.
Right. Hey, so I'm going to show you this trailer, right? If you've never seen it, it's Spike Lee's Bamboozled trailer, right? It came out back in the 90s. Play that. Let's show you. He's going to show you how blackface still exists today. White people don't dress up with putting blackface on and go on TV like that. He's going to show you how it went from overt to covert blackface. Let it play.
Right.
I want a show that will make headlines. The Huxtables, Cosby, a genius, revolutionary, but we can't go down that road again.
The network does not want to see Negroes on television unless they are buffoons.
Have you ever thought about just quitting?
I have a contract. The only way I get out of that is if I get fired, and that is what I intend to do. I know you are familiar with minstrel shows, variety show, like in Living Color.
Right, that was dope.
Mantan, the new millennium minstrel show.
We're gonna need a little more money for this.
This could be bigger than Friends, Ally McBeal, even my boys Amos and Andy.
Damn. You're putting white actors in blackface?
We're using black actors with blacker faces.
Pause it. Hollywood. That's how it went from covert to overt.
Bring it out.
White folks don't dress up blackface no more. They use niggas to do it now.
Do the work for them. Do the work for them.
Negroes dress up in blackface by being buffoons on TV.
Right, right.
You don't win Oscars unless you're a slave.
Yep.
Unless you're abusive mama.
Right.
You in an interracial marriage. You turn around and let the white man bang you out.
Yeah. Right.
You have real sex on camera. That's what Halle Berry did. She had real sex on camera with Billy Bob Thornton, and they gave her an Oscar for it. You had to be the help, a servant, back in the 50s to get an Oscar.
The new blackface.
That's the new blackface. They got Negroes dressing up like buffoons, Madea, Big Mama's House, comedians like Kevin Hart. That's blackface now. Let it play out. Let that thing play.
This fall.
Right on, man.
Yeah, great show.
You won't believe what's coming to your television.
Sleep and Eat and Mantan are lazy and unemployed.
Do your stuff.
But we are certainly not saying anything about the entire African American community.
What's sweeping the nation? And what's coloring? The way you see the world.
Yo, we can't let this injustice go by, man. Not this time, man.
You know what I'm saying?
Nah, man. You know what I'm saying?
You know what I mean? You know what I'm saying?
How about raising up?
They all had that sound left.
When are you gonna come into the light?
The light.
The light.
Your hands are just as bloody as mine.
Cousins, I want straight in the
main. Let it play.
I want you all to go to your windows. We talking about revolution. Go to your windows and yell out, I am not gonna take it anymore!
Bamboozled.
I don't want anything to do with anything black for at least a week.
Pause it there. Go to the next video. So that's how they do it. That's how blackface ain't changed. So do you know that question DL said, has America changed? It ain't changed. No, not at all. Negroes is just sleep. They blind to it. Right, now look at the montage. This is in the actual movie. If you never seen Bamboozle, go and watch that movie. This is in the actual movie that he put a history together of blackface, right? Let it play.
You this evening?
Me?
Oh, boy. I'm the personification of health, Mr. Christie.
Good.
Who was that lady I saw you with this afternoon?
That was no lady. That was my wife.
It was in the cartoons. Lazy dancing Negroes, that's all we do. Eating chicken, watermelon. Let's stop it right there. Let's stop it right there because it's 3 minutes or so. It goes on showing you all the videos and cartoons and stuff where we was just getting straight up disrespected and black faces, lazy, shiftless, watermelon chicken dancing Negroes from the time they let us on camera. That's all they would let us do. We're going to skip that video right there. We're going to skip that video. Now, look, this is today. So how does it play up to today? Stereotypes of African Americans, right? Scroll down some. I'm going to get straight to the point on this. Scroll down some more. Scroll down. All right, here we go. Okay, look at this. Historical stereotypes, right? Minstrel shows. That's what we was just watching with the blackface. Portrayed and lampooned black people in stereotypical and often disparaging ways as ignorant, lazy, buffoonish, superstitious, joyous, and musical. Blackface is a style of theatrical makeup in the United States used to affect the countenance of an iconic racist American archetype, that of the darky or coon. White blackface performers in the past used the burnt cork and later grease paint or shoe polish to blacken their skin and exaggerate their lips, often wearing woolly wigs, gloves, tailcoats, or ragged clothes for to complete the transformation. The best known stock character of this sort is Jim Crow. That's that picture you see up to your right over there. That's Jim Crow, the lazy, shiftless, dancing Negro, right? Scroll down. Let me show you something. Scroll down. So here's some of the characters they made. Jim Crow, Sambo, Gollywig, and Pickaninny. Go ahead. Mammy, Mandingo. We ain't got time to read all of this. This is the sexualized Negro, right? Mm-hmm. Sapphire, Jezebel. Hold on. Jezebel was in every way a counter image of the mid-19th century ideal of a Victorian lady. The idea that the black women are sexual promiscuous stemmed from Europeans' first encounter with African women. Go down. Tragic mulatta. That's a stereotype that was popular in early Hollywood. The tragic mulatta served as a cautionary tale for black people. The tragic mulatta was usually depicted as a sexually attractive, light-skinned woman of African-American descent who could pass for Caucasian. Go down.
Hey, you know what's crazy? All of those that have not repented fall into one of those categories.
Best believe it. Yeah. Best believe it.
Yeah. Everybody fall into one of those categories.
The savage. Another stereotype was that of the savage, an African black people who were usually depicted as primitive, simple, childlike, or cannibalistic persons who live in tribes and carry spears, believe in witchcraft, and worship the wizard. Go down. Uncle Tom, good old Uncle Tom, stereotype presents black men who are not so much intelligent, unintelligent, simple-minded, and subdued, but more so primarily interested in the welfare and advancement of white people or persons over the interests of other black people. Every black person out there celebrating 4th of July. Right. Uncle Tom's.
Wearing red, that's, white, and blue.
Red, white, and blue. Uncle Tom's, because 1776, that means that you are for the welfare and advancement of white people,
right,
not your own.
Not your own. Mm.
Go there. So look, modern stereotypes. That was back then. How's it modern? Go down. Crack addicts and drug dealers.
Damn.
You see that on TV all the time.
There we go.
Verse 48, Law and Order. Go down. Watermelon stereotype. You see that? Fried chicken. Go down. The welfare queen. Go down. The magical Negro. Go down. The angry black woman.
Oh, man.
Sheesh.
Go down. Keep going. Let's see if it's any more. Oh, the black bitch. Go down. The independent black woman. We see these, right? Go ahead. The black athlete.
Oh, man.
We see that all the time.
These are categories, man, that our oppressors put us in.
Yep.
That's right. How they see.
Go down.
One thing you don't see is the Israelite. You don't see that category up there.
The unintelligent. Go ahead. Okay, so that was then and this now. So it ain't changed, right? Let's go to the next article. Let's show you this. Still, the blackface is just went off of them and it was put on black people. That's it. That's why you got so many buffoons. Now look at this. Here's your ultimate blackface today.
They call it black fishing right there.
Yeah.
Look at this.
White Instagram influencers pretending to be black. My style is my own.
Bull crap.
Watch this. Look at this. White women are masquerading as black women is Instagram's newest craze. It is calculated the cultural appropriation. Rachel Dolezal-esque delusion or both. Look at that picture right there. All three of them, white women.
Eat them.
All three of them, white girls.
Yeah.
All three of them. Scroll down. Now, I'm not going to read this. I'm going to get straight to the point. Go to the pictures. You see them right there, right? Go to the pictures.
Go down.
It's the pictures on Telegram. We're going to do one by one to show you what we're looking at. Click on it. Boom. All right, right there. Excuse the whoredom, right?
Modesty, right?
So you see her, right? You look at her, you be like, oh, dang, that's a beautiful black woman right
Israelite
there.
Israelite woman right there, right?
Israelite got her hair, her eye nail, her eyebrows
got
done, right? The lip gloss is popping.
So she got good hair.
She
good
got
hair.
The the highlights on, right?
Right.
Go to the next picture. Right, so this is her Instagram picture. Man, look at her. She's pretty light-skinned black girl. Wow, the wavy hair, the weave. Oh, okay. Go to the next picture. Hey!
What happened?
Oh, what the hell? Good God of
hell.
Hey! What happened?
What happened?
Yes, that's the witchcraft, y'all.
That is her.
Somebody give us
black face.
Almond milk.
That's the magical name.
Black face.
Oh, yes. Man.
Sheesh. Go to the next picture. So this is the other one that you saw, right? You saw it. Be like, oh, so dudes, you know, whoremonger dude. Like, oh, dang, she's thick. BBW black girl right there, man.
Right,
oh,
right.
Man, fine. All right?
Right.
You see her, right? Alicia. Go to the next picture. Oh, you got them out of order. Okay, so this is the other one. This is the other one that we was at just a second ago, right? That's her on the left, and that's her on the right. Now, look what she says at the bottom right here, right? Before and after. The left picture was taken 2 years ago, right before summer, with barely any makeup, and my hair was straightened. The right picture was taken in July, right after I came home from vacation with makeup.
Come on.
You show me one Edomite, one white girl
on,
that in a summer gets that damn black and it stays on you.
So
you, what the hell are you, a chameleon?
Look,
boom.
This is the makeup right
black
here.
Black face.
What color makeup that is right there?
That's brown. Black face, modern black face.
Shame, man.
The hell are you, a chameleon? You transform every winter and summer. Your brown just leaves you and you turn pale.
Hey, but they let you know what the beauty of the world is.
Oh, yeah, it's us.
The beauty is us.
It's us.
They want to be us, but they don't want the struggle that come behind us.
Yep. Go to the next photo. So you saw that other girl, right? So go back to.
That's her.
Go back to. Go right there. Right so there. You see her, right? That's her right there, right? Keep going. Go over those other two. That was her a few
right
years
there.
Ago.
Come on.
Show me where Becky becomes 200 pounds more weight heavier, and then she just, the heavier she gets, the darker she gets.
Right.
What the hell? What in the hell what is the going hell? On and here?
Who you think they aiming for?
Yeah.
Who you think they aiming for when they do all that?
Jake.
They aiming for you, brothers. You brothers. They stick with the most high call them a snare and a trap.
Yep.
Yeah, trap for who? For you. You're going to be caught up in that trap right
now.
Now,
look at this. You think that's bad, right? They ain't the ultimate blackface women on the face of the earth. Go to the next picture. Let me show you something. Next article. Go to the next article. Go out of that. Go to the next article. Somebody help. Where we at?
Come on now.
Uh-oh. What name is that?
Here we go.
Kim Kardashian. What are you doing, man? I can't see. Kim Kardashian slammed for calling cornrows. Who got cornrows? What people on the face of the earth? It's us.
Israel, right.
You don't see Becky walking around with right. braids in her hair right. like Kawhi Leonard and stuff, right? She called cornrows Bo Derek braids. If you don't know nothing about Bo Derek, it's back in 1979 or something. A white lady braided her hair and put little beads on the end like all the black girls in the hood right, do on right. a regular basis.
So hold on. So she giving the credit to
a white woman back
woman.
In the 70s. Yeah. Black people like, what?
No.
Becky, please. That ain't nothing but damn cornrows.
Right. Right. Only time Becky get her hair braided is when she go to the islands.
That's it. That's it.
They go to the islands, get off the ship,
let me go
and they go find a Negro to yep. braid their hair.
Yep. Scroll
right
down.
When you get off the in Bahamas, yeah. they do that. They have a
no thanks. Yeah.
What they call that? A little spot Stop. Right there.
Yeah. Eccentric braids.
Look at this.
This is Becky's real hair on the left, and she got her hair braided and call it Bo Derek braids.
And who she trapped?
Hey, who did she snare?
Who did
hey,
he snare?
Kanye.
Oh, Kanye, man. Reggie Bush.
Who did she trap?
Damn.
Yeah.
Who?
Ray J. Oh,
Ray J. You see what cop of hell he got in his head now.
There you go.
Yeah. So look, that's blackface right there. She didn't put the paint on her face, but she showed it Jack Black woman style and got her a black man.
There you go.
Now she trying to look like Northern Kingdom or something.
Yep.
She
from Armenia. But it gets even worse. It gets worse than her. Go to the next article. Let's see. Hold on, wait. It says, look at this right here.
Hold on, brother.
What are lip fillers? What were we talking about lip fillers? What's going on? Black folk don't need lip fillers.
Don't
we
worry
don't
about
need
that.
That. What you talking about?
You got to worry about
we
how
were
much
born
do
with
they cost? Are they safe? And did Kylie Jenner,
here we go.
Kim Kardashian's sister, have her lip fillers removed? Scroll down some. Look at this here.
Oh, God.
Damn. So this is what
head.
They do.
Hey,
watch this. I'm going to show you. Hey, get the video ready to load up. I'm going to show you how blackface went from covert to overt. So they want to be you. They want to dance like you. They want the hair like you. They want the lips like you, right?
They inject,
they Botox their lips. They want the bodies like you, right? So look what they did now. Look what they did. They stopped painting the faces, but they took all of your features. Mm. Look what they do with these lip fillers. Go to the video.
Hey guys, thank you so much for watching.
We only go watch about a minute. Pause it.
I'm going to do
the. We're only going to watch it. Look,
hey,
she's woo. Becky.
She don't even got lips.
None.
For real, none.
Now we only gonna watch about a minute. I want to hear
what
she says.
Right, whole jaw.
We only gonna watch a few minutes of this to see what she says in the beginning, how unnatural it is for them, right? And then we're gonna show you how to do it. Go ahead, let it play.
The video I promised I was gonna do about candy lips.
It's a product I kind of stumbled across, and I decided to order it, give it a shot, see how it works. I love big, juicy, plumpy lips.
Pause it.
And I have.
She loves big, on, juicy, on, plumpy lips.
Who got big, juicy, plumpy lips?
Right. Come on, I love them.
All right.
I love them lips.
Israel.
Don't give me that color, though. I don't, no, I don't want the color no more. Just give me that features.
Right. Give me their features. Goodness.
You heard what she said, right?
Some of them old Edomites, they can't do this.
Big
what they do, they put the makeup up there.
Yeah, yeah,
look
yeah.
Look
make the lips look bigger the than they are. All right, let that play a little bit more.
I've had Juvederm injections twice now. I did really love my injections, but I kind of feel like I don't really know what I'm injecting into my lips.
What?
It could cause cancer down the road. It could be harmful down the road. And although I'd love to look beautiful, I don't think that it's worth it, in my opinion. So I was kind of on the hunt for something that could deliver the same look without the harmful side effects. So moving along.
All right, let's pause. So look. You know, I don't know what I'm injecting. It ain't for you.
Right.
God didn't make you to look like us. He didn't. You ain't the perfection of His beauty. We are. So you're doing all kind of stuff. That's Kylie Jenner right there with her lip fillers. You're doing everything you can to try to have your modern day black face. Your modern-day blackface is what you're doing, right? Go back to the video. Now, look how they do it. Look how they do. They get their lips plump and juicy, right? Play that.
This one.
Hey, guys. Welcome to part two of my pink Kylie Jenner-inspired makeup look. And this is all about the lips this time, the ultimate lip plumping tutorial. I'll be showing you how to get plump lips like Kylie Jenner and all of those Kardashians.
Pause it.
So if you want to...
Look, not plump lips like black people.
Right.
Plump lips like Kylie Jenner.
And the Kardashians.
You see that?
Like there they invented plump
like they
lips.
Invented right. plump yeah. lips. Like that belongs to them. Mm-hmm. Mm. See, I'm telling you, man. Never trust thy enemy.
Never, ever.
Never trust
because they want to erase us and replace us.
Yep, exactly.
That's exactly
right.
What they want to do.
Exactly
they can't do
right,
it.
The same way they did with our heritage, they want to do the same thing.
It ain't happening.
It. That's not happening.
Yeah, we got you now, baby. Play that thing.
I'm going to find out how I created this pink pout thing. Keep watching. So these are my lips before any plumping or product application.
Hey!
Good God! Woo! Look at that head, bro. I'm telling you, man.
Lips look dead.
Chap as hell. Chap as hell. Pale ass lips, man. All right, let it play. Let it play. Let it play, man. You'll see the difference.
I'm just going to use my EOS lip balm
no
to smooth
lip
out my chap lips. And now...
Let it play, man. Come on.
Onto the plumping. These are candy lips, and I cannot wait because I'm going to be stocking these on my website. So
this is
keep
how
a look
they do
out
it,
and
y'all.
You're going to order them off of ccclark.com very soon. Now, these are probably the most extreme lip plumpers.
Yeah.
You can
this
leave them on anywhere between 2 and 4 minutes, and I've opted in with the double-lobed lip effect. So that means the line down the bottom of your middle lip, a bit like Angelina Jolie. She's got the contour line
like
down
Angelina
the middle.
Like Angelina Jolie.
Wow. As you can see, it creates kind of two pockets of juicy plumpness. Now on to full lips. Again, I do stock these two. We've
Look
got the medium
this.
Oval, small oval, and the large round. I'm going in with the large round. The difference between these and the candy lips, I'd say, is that you can kind of turn your lips up and out with these. As you see, I'm not placing my whole mouth and lips inside the full lips enhancer. I'm actually kind of turning my lips up, and any lines that are created around my lips, or wrinkles as people keep calling them, they actually just rub away. As you can see, I'm using my medium oval now, vertically and horizontally.
Blackface.
I love this because it really does
modern day blackface.
It creates more of a pout, and you can see this is after much more full.
This is how they do it. This is how they do it, y'all. All right, I'm done with Becky. I'm done with Becky's ass. I don't want to see her
hey,
no more.
Hey, but hold on, Cap. I remember when this was, what they call it, the Kylie Jenner Challenge?
Yeah.
They used to do it with bottles.
Yeah, that's what they were doing.
They actually making money off this
Now brand. They made an actual product to do it for white girls to get their lips big, right? blackface. They was painting their lips big, making fun of us. Now, Kylie Jenner did it. Now they made a product to get big, juicy, plump lips like black folk and make money off of it.
Wow. And don't give them the credit. Follow right behind them.
Yep.
Big, juicy lips already, and then they start sucking on a dang old
whatever that thing is. Hey. So look. It used to be called blackface, right? Go to the next article to show you what it, the modern day term. This is how they just, it's overt. It's just, you know, it's the mystery Babylon. This is what it's called now. Cultural appropriation. That is the new modern day term for Jim Crow. And look who they got next to it. East. Look who they got over there.
$5.
Look at that. They got
$5 Indian.
Hello. Look at that. Look at that.
Look at this dude. He look like straight from the Caucasus Mountain.
Caucasus Mountain. Viking hat.
Look at this. This is what it, this is the modern day term for blackface. It's called cultural appropriation. At times also phrased cultural misappropriation is the adoption of elements of one culture by members of another culture. This can be controversial when members of a dominant culture appropriate from disadvantaged minority cultures. Wasn't that the same damn thing they was doing when they was painting their face and dancing back in during the Jim Crow era? That's exactly the same thing they was doing. Taking our looks and then they was using it for their benefit of the disadvantaged minority cultures, making money off of us. Cultural appropriation is the modern day term for blackface.
So now basically they was making fun of us back then to humiliate us, but now it's turned into a where now it's a mental sickness trying to look like us now.
Yep.
Hey, let me get a script.
Pull it, man.
Micah 2:2.
Mosiah genius, man, I tell you.
Get Micah 2:2, man.
Micah 2:2.
Start at verse 1.
Verse 1.
Come on.
Woe to them that devise iniquity and work evil upon their beds.
This is talking about the so-called white man.
There you go.
Woe, destruction. Jump to verse 2. Watch this.
Verse 2. And they covet fields.
They covet fields.
And take them by violence.
Watch this.
And houses and take them away. So they oppress a man and his house.
Read.
Even a man and his heritage.
They want damn everything.
They want your lips. They want your color.
Your slang.
They want your slang. They want your style.
Damn.
All of that. Cultural appropriation is modern day term for blackface. That's it. Go to that next article. It gets worse. It gets worse.
Oh, Lord.
Yeah. It gets worse.
Bring it out.
Exit out. Let's see what we got here. We destroyed her. Look, that's Kylie Jenner right there with the braids, right? Yeah. So they started doing the braids. Go to the next one. Let's move on. All right. So look. Has America changed? Right. You see that? Black lives. Scroll down. Black Lives Matter. You see all the names: Eric Garner, Mike Brown, MLK, Emmett Till, Jordan Davis, the brother in Ohio with the toy gun, shot him down in Walmart. Right. Black Lives Matter. Let's see. How's it changed? Let's see what they used to do. So it says, read that for me, Soldier Lyle.
The racist roots of America policing from slave patrols to traffic stops.
From slave patrols to traffic stops, right? Scroll down to slave patrol. Read that.
Slave patrols. There are two historical narratives about the origins of America law enforcement. Policing and Southern slave holding states had roots in slave patrols, squadrons made up of white volunteers empowered to use vigilante tactics to enforce laws related to slavery.
Uh-huh.
They located and returned enslaved people who had escaped, crushed uprisings led by enslaved people and punished enslaved workers found or believed to have violated plantation rules.
If they violated plantation rules, right? Read on.
The first slave patrols arose in South Carolina in the early 1700s. As University of Georgia social worker Professor Michael A. Robinson has written, by the time John Adams became the second U.S. president Every state that had not yet abolished slavery had them.
Every state had a slave patrol, right? Read on.
Members of slave patrols could forcefully enter anyone's home.
Damn.
Regardless of their race or ethnicity.
Ethnicity.
Based on suspicions that they were sheltering people who had escaped bondage.
All right, jump to the next prayer where it says the first police.
The first police forces were overwhelmingly white, male, and are more focused on responding to disorder than crime.
All right, so that's slave patrol, right? That's what used to happen back then, right? Scroll down. Let's see the next topic. Scroll down. So you had Jim Crow laws, right? That was back then. We know. We just went over a little bit of what Jim Crow was happening, right? But Jim Crow slave patrols formally dissolved after the Civil War ended, but formerly enslaved people saw little relief from racist government policies as they promptly became subject to black codes. So you went from slave patrols to black codes, right? And Jim Crow laws. That lasted 80 or so years, all right? Let's see what happened in modern day times. Scroll down. Let's see if it changed. Keep going down. So, reverberating today. For the past 5 decades, the federal government has forbidden the use of racist regulations at the state and local level. Yet people of color are still more likely to be killed by the police than whites. Washington Post tracks the number of Americans killed by the police by race, gender, and other characteristics. The newspaper database indicates that 229 out of 992 of those who died that way in 2018, 23% of the total were black, even though only about 12% of the country is African American. Mm. So we was more of us getting killed than any other race, right? Scroll down some more. Let's see if anything else on that. Go to the next one. Let's go to the video. I think it's a video after this, right? Let's show you something. Let's show you a little bit of something here, right? We're seeing if it changed. Let's skip the racial profiling. Go straight to the article of the black patient, the video, the black patient, right? We still getting racial profile. We know that, right? Racial profile, the practice of targeting people on a particular color, right? Go to the, yeah, this is it. This is it right here, right? Black patient recovering from pneumonia arrested after following doctor's orders to take a walk. Let's see if it's been racially profiled. Let's see if it's still slave patrol out there going on. Play that. Let's see, is that a video? I don't think it is a video, right? Okay, let's read the second paragraph. Dude had pneumonia, right? Go ahead, read that.
Shaquille Dukes, a 24...
No, the second paragraph.
I was stopped by an overzealous racist security officer who claimed that I was trying to leave the hospital to sell the IV equipment on eBay.
Wow, that, yeah. How the hell he come up with that conclusion?
Yeah. Security guard saw him walking outside, going back to the hospital, and stopped him. You trying to sell it on eBay. It was a slave roaming around, and the slave patrol caught him. Read on.
A white security guard and police officers allegedly racially profiled Dukes. In short, they accused him of trying to steal his hospital IV and sell it on eBay. After what might have ended at a miscommunication, it escalated into him being arrested and placed in a cop car.
Now listen, it says after what might have ended, what is supposed to say, it should have ended in a miscommunication, but because he was a black man, they had to put him in a police car.
Yep. Right. Yep. Read on.
As they began to take me to the car, I told them I never left the hospital property. And that's when he, a police officer, turned and said, "Well, you're off hospital property now," Dukes told ABC News in an interview.
Let's go, nigga. Get in the car. Go ahead.
When Dukes was guided toward the security officer's car, he was technically no longer on hospital property, which technically violated the rules.
So they took him off the property to put him in the police car.
Hey, that's wicked as hell, man.
Yeah.
Wicked as hell.
Which technically violated the rules he'd been given from the hospital. According to Dukes, the security officer then called the police. While being arrested, Dukes says that the cops took his inhaler from him.
They were trying to kill him.
Yeah, they're trying to kill him. The brother's suffering from pneumonia and he got asthma.
Yep.
Right.
They was trying to kill the dude, man.
Because pneumonia affects your lungs.
Yeah.
You can't breathe. You get what certain infections in your lungs. So that's what causes pneumonia.
Read that next paragraph. Look what happened to him in the back of the car. Read that.
While in transit, I began to have a seizure.
Because they taking him to jail in his hospital gown. They are taking the dude to jail in his hospital gown. Read on.
And subsequently, an asthma attack.
Uh-huh.
I pleaded with the officers for almost 4 minutes to retrieve my inhaler from the transporter's officer. And finally, when I became unresponsive, it miraculously appeared, he explained on Facebook.
He was a slave on the loose, and the slave patrol caught him, put him in the squad car, and took him back to the big house.
Think about it, man. The man got on a hospital gown. The man got on a hospital gown, man.
No clothes underneath of
him. Wear hospital socks. So you know them socks the hospital give you? He got on hospital
blue socks. Blue socks,
Taking the advice of the doctor to walk up and down, and then next thing you know, you going to jail.
That's crazy.
Nearly died.
You know you almost died.
That's the live video right there?
No, this is another video, right? Now scroll down on this right here. Scroll down on this. Let me see. Okay, let's see. Let's play the video. If it plays, play the video, man. Is it playing?
That's a picture.
Okay, screenshot. Okay, all right. So let's go to the next video to show you where in their eyes they saw a slave on the loose and they had him put him back in his place. Right? Let it play. We almost finished here.
I'm telling you to stop, and I'm not gonna tell you again.
And what will you do if I don't stop?
I will detain you.
They say that they keep getting calls that a black guy is walking around their neighborhood.
Pause it.
I am being raped.
Just off that alone.
There you go.
They keep getting caught with a black guy walking around. Well, damn it, we're in America. You know how many black men are in America?
There you go.
Hey, that goes back to what you was talking about earlier about the network.
The neighborhood.
A spook.
Right.
Yep.
Right.
A spook. Look, check this. Ain't nobody out on the streets. Ain't nobody running up calling him nigga in his face and spitting on him and throwing rocks no more. All they did was look out the window. Spook alert.
Call the slave patrol.
Police, call the slave patrol.
They just keep getting orders that a black guy is walking around in the neighborhood.
Yep. That's it. That's all they needed to hear.
That's it.
I am being racially profiled. This is the second day in a row. Let it play.
Racially profiled. This is the second day in a row. I am out campaigning.
West Des Moines, Iowa police.
So it's not a big deal.
Yeah, no, I'm just trying to figure out what we were concerned about.
Well, in West Des Moines, we haven't solicited an ordinance.
Hill's canvassing for a Republican congressman. So he's basically putting those little
voting
yard signs and stuff like that for, like you see it back there, the Republican type stuff to go vote, right, for this certain dude. So they called the police on him because they thought he was being suspicious. Let it play.
Okay, so that being said, I'd like you to leave me alone, sir. I have not broken any laws.
Said he's soliciting.
They use the right words, man. Yeah.
Now, soliciting is hanging outside of an area or in an area and trying to sell something.
Right.
That's what soliciting is, like trying to hang in front of a corner store and sell burnt CDs like Judah be trying to do.
Right?
Five for 20 movies, that type stuff, right? That's what soliciting is. Let it play.
Soliciting is what? Offering services.
Yeah.
I'm not offering a service.
Okay. Got him.
Okay.
The cop agreed. Oh, okay. Okay.
Well, I'm still doing an investigation because if you're in the room, I'm still recording too, so it's okay.
Investigating what, sir?
So you see the body cam on the left and the phone on the right.
Suspicious how?
A neighbor called over here, so he's I don't suspicious. Understand why you're being difficult.
Listen
about
what
this.
He said. A neighbor called.
Now he's saying you haven't done anything. You're being
back.
Difficult.
Okay. Hey, go back some. Go back a little bit.
Listen, I'm telling you, man, these dudes, they know the wordplay to use.
Yeah.
Now you're being difficult.
Let it play.
Now what the kid the kid is doing though, see where his hands are.
Yeah, yeah. That he could have got shot.
Meant
death.
Yep. Yeah. It could have. It sure could have. I saw that, I was thinking about that, man.
Too much movements. Gone. Go ahead.
Because I haven't done anything out of the way.
Okay.
So with that being said, I'll go about my business.
Okay, I'm not done with you yet. You're not free to go.
Have I done it? Have I broken any laws?
4255. Can you send me one this way, please?
He's uncooperative. Have I broken any laws, sir?
I'm talking to you. I'm not done. I'm investigating a suspicious person.
You have a nice day, sir.
Stop. Stop now.
For what?
I can detain you. Stop.
For what?
Because you're not listening. I'm investigating a suspicious person. Stop
sir,
now.
Sir, have I broken any laws?
Stop.
Y'all see where his hand at?
I told you to stop.
I don't have to stop.
Yes.
You know you I don't. Either arrest me, tell me what laws I broke.
Can you step it up? He's being uncooperative and trying to walk away from me.
He's just walking around on the loose, right?
I know my right. And with that being said, if I've not broken any laws, you have no reason to detain me.
Stop.
So I'm going to ask you one more time.
I'm going to tell you to stop.
For what?
Because I'm talking to you and you're
not done this wrong.
I just told you I'm investigating who you are.
You're harassing me.
5700 block of Aspen. Stop. I'm telling you to stop. And I'm
send the cavalry.
And what will you do if I don't stop?
I will detain you.
Detain me for what?
You're not listening. I'm doing an investigation of a suspicious person.
A suspicious person? Have I broken any laws?
Listen.
That's not the point.
Have I broken any laws?
Someone called you and it's a suspicious person.
Okay. And? You can be a suspicious person. Mr.
Really?
Ray?
Listen.
Really?
I feel like you're a suspicious person.
How would I be suspicious?
You look suspicious to me.
Okay. How would that be? I'm in a marked
police
car.
You're a white man. You're suspicious to me.
I'm suspicious to you because I'm a white person.
Yeah, with a gun. You're suspicious to me.
No,
now,
stop.
Get away from me. I haven't done anything out of the way. You can't arrest me. Arrest me right now if you want to.
Here, turn around. Put your hands on your back.
For what?
Because
what have I done wrong, sir?
Get the phone out of my face. Because you're not. I'm investigating
sir,
a suspicious person.
Sir, what have
person.
I done wrong? I'm not suspicious. I haven't done anything. I'm walking up the street.
Hold on. Let it play. Let it go get better right here.
Sir, I don't care if anyone has called on me. This is not your. This is not their. Area. The
this
street,
is a, actually this is a public roadway, so this
okay,
means
okay, okay.
Boom.
It's a public roadway.
Right, it's public.
That means that I have the right to be on this roadway. Yes or no?
He's still walking. Got him. Being uncooperative and refusing.
It's a public roadway, so why can't a black man walk on a public roadway?
Do anything. If I've not broken any laws, I don't have.
Westbound, we were 58th and Aspen.
Go ahead, pause it. Walking down in a white neighborhood, public property. Slave on the loose.
There you go.
Call the slave patrol.
I tell you this, right? I have a little bit of experience in this, right?
Uh-huh.
If he knew that he had a crime that was committed, one stop and then is detained. Mm-hmm. There's no 50, sir, please stop. Please stop. He's going to ask me, please stop. Please stop, sir. And trying to explain himself. If you're confident that this guy has broken a law, and or in the midst of breaking a law, whatever, there's no Mr. Sir stop nothing.
Right. Right.
You're detained until whatever. There's he said it 50 times.
That's
because
he know he ain't got nothing.
Right. He walking behind him with his hands in his pocket.
He was called by the good old folks that a slave was walking around in our neighborhood. He's suspicious. Come get him off our streets. Hey, pull up that picture. Pull up the picture. Somebody put this picture up a while ago. And to show you how it ain't changed. It just transformed. A picture, what they say a picture's worth of what?
A thousand words,
right? They used to hide, the KKK, they used to hide behind cloaks with their face covered. And he had some slaves chained up behind him. And he just passed the torch on to the police department.
Yep. There's some pictures out there where some police officers in uniform doing some hand sign, standing white people. They sit there with the little sign on their hand.
Yep.
Yeah, white power, right?
White power.
Yeah. White
power.
Yeah.
WP.
Mm-hmm. Pictures worth a thousand words. They used to hang Negroes, beat them and kill them up under the Confederate flag and pass the power on to the police and the justice system. And you see all the dead, some of the dead faces that they choose to publicize right up under the police. It ain't changed at all, folks. Not one single bit. Let's play that last video right here and see what D.L. Hughley says about black people here in America. Play that last video.
Hey, before we get to that,
go ahead.
It's something called, skip that. We're not doing that. But I'm just going to briefly talk about it. Just skip it. It's something called Sundown Towns. Yep. It's what, back then, Esau would.
So if you've been paying any attention at all.
Black person going through their neighborhoods, they will beat you, or you had to pay a fee to actually go through their neighborhoods. And it was saying how those sundown towns are still established today.
Wow.
They're still established today with the black, not black, but white owned towns. And they actually put up signs where it tell you no Negroes allowed. But it's not right, or no trespassing.
Or they still got them.
They still got them today. Wow. That's why a lot of towns, like you see like old, like Mississippi,
yeah,
Alabama, you just keep driving.
Keep on going. I don't care.
You don't stop.
Push the car.
Chainsaw massacre towns.
Yep. Hey, before we play this video and close it out on that, go to that article, I'm Going to Be a Black Man, to show you how all nations make a mockery of us. They steal your lips. They steal your hair. They put the black face on you now. Stereotype you. Has America got any better since the 70s? Let's read that for me, Soldier Lyle.
I'm going to be a black man. Man goes to court wearing black face after being convicted of road rage incident.
He had the audacity to go to court with black face to prove a point, right? Scroll down some. Y'all seen right there, right? Scroll down.
Look at this.
This is Hawaii. This is Japheth over there. If you didn't know, this is Hawaii, right? A Hawaiian man wore blackface and went on a racist rant in court because he claimed he was treated unfairly by the justice system, by the slave patrollers, right? Go down. Let's play the video. Play that. Let's listen to him.
Now this kangaroo court is giving
Turn it
me
up.
A life sentence for me trying to protect and defend myself against the attack from three guys. In essence, treating me like a black man.
Mm.
You almost killed an innocent motorist.
No, it didn't happen that way.
You cut off the evidence showed, Mr.
There was no evidence on my part. Mr. My lawyer Charles. Failed. Treating me like a black man, so today I'm going to be a black man.
Damn.
That's it.
Stop.
Yeah.
Maybe y'all didn't see. Maybe that didn't sink in what he's saying. Woo. Y'all treat me like a black man, therefore I'm just gonna dress. I'm just gonna
paint
look
my
like,
face
a black.
Like a black man. And
basically what he said,
show up to court.
Hey, basically what he said is, y'all know I'm not black, right?
Yeah.
I'm not
Why
black.
You treat
Why you
me
treat
like
me
that?
Like
you
a black man?
Like that.
Wow.
I'm innocent. I just killed three people. Hell, I'm not black, so I should be getting off.
Yep.
So basically, when you get convicted, you are treated like a black man.
There you go.
And there was a super loud silence. When he said that, the judge got a big old fur ball in his throat.
But that just lets you know that mocking us as a people, mocking us means nothing to them. And this is a Hawaiian dude. It means nothing to him where he ain't got no remorse of painting his face black and just showing up to court. To get his point across, all nations make a mind. We become a reproach to all nations.
And then
man.
They let him walk in the courtroom.
They
like
let
that.
Him walk in like that.
Right.
So he got out. Remember, he was in a jail cell. He got out the jail cell, transported to the courtroom, and was allowed in the court.
Yep.
Like that.
I was
that.
Just going to say that because he in orange jumpsuit.
Yeah.
So he was locked up.
With a magic
Wonder
marker.
Why he get the black.
Went to town.
Sheesh.
Hey, let me get a script real
go ahead,
quick.
Go ahead,
all right, because I know we've been pulling some scriptures, some articles, those downers, but we're going to pick y'all up. Give me Baruch chapter 4, verse 25, real quick. All right.
Baruch chapter 4 and verse 25.
Come on.
My children, suffer patiently.
It says suffer patiently. We've seen all these atrocities happen. We getting jacked up. Our enemies mocking us, trying to be us. Read.
the wrath that has come upon you from God.
Come on.
For thine enemy hath persecuted thee.
Mm-hmm. Persecuted us. Come on.
But shortly.
It says shortly. Come on.
Thou shalt see his destruction.
We will see the destruction of those.
That's right.
Shortly.
Read
That's
on. Right.
And shall tread upon his neck.
Ooh, that right there should tuck you in right now. Yeah. Get you ready for tomorrow.
Tread all right? upon his
Get
neck.
You read that again. Say, tuck
you in. Go and ahead. Shall tread upon his neck.
We're going to tread upon his neck. Read.
My delicate ones have gone rough ways.
Come on.
And were taken away as a flock caught of the enemies.
Come on.
Be of good comfort.
Here you go. Be of good comfort. Why? Read.
O my children. And cry unto God, for ye shall be remembered of him that brought these things upon you.
See that? So though these things are happening to you, it says be of good comfort,
yep.
because we will be treading upon
that's
their
right.
necks.
God they all going to have to feel it,
right?
man.
That's right.
Yep, for making a mockery of us.
There we go.
Ain't nothing changed, man, at all. Let's play that last video.
Action. So if you've been paying any attention at all to social media over the last few months, you will notice a rash of phenomenon occurring. There are any number of people who are pulling guns on black people. There was an incident in Georgia where a young white woman, claims that she was cut off or involved in a traffic altercation. She follows a 60-some-year-old black man home. She guns him down after being told by the dispatcher not to. Much like George Zimmerman, she guns him down, kills him in his own driveway. And she claims that she was afraid for her life. We just saw earlier in the show a young couple. They go to an RV park in Mississippi, although why, I don't understand. And they were greeted by an owner with a gun who pulled a gun on them because she basically said you didn't have reservations. So I don't know if... not having reservations is tantamount to giving somebody the death penalty. We've watched three police officers, as a matter of fact. One on social media this weekend asked for the young man to show his hands. He refused to do it. Then he yells, he's got a gun. He said, I don't have a gun. Then the young man refused to reach for his wallet because you could clearly see what was happening. He pulled his gun, hoping something would happen. When he yelled he had a gun, what do you think was the desired result? There's another time, also on social media, a young couple, while he's being asked for his driver's license, that couple gets a gun pulled on them. This is not by accident. I think the public has seen, and the message is very clear, you can do what you want because you will not be held to account. Over and over and over again. Tell me, what is the training involved in walking up in a routine traffic stop and you see the color of the person involved and pulling your service revolver or your service gun and keeping it on them the whole time? What is the point of going to an RV campground and somebody pulling a gun on you just and we're not talking about hordes of young men. We're talking about couples where somebody pulls guns on them. I think there is a spirit in this country right now where a great deal of people believe that they can do what they want and nobody would be brought to account for them. Every time there's a grand jury who says there's not enough evidence to acquit, every time there is a jury that says we won't find anybody guilty, you tell America the same story is always heard. It's okay to do what you want to us. So you can't take these responsibilities. There are now laws being put in place in several states that say you can't just call the police on black people just because. We watched a police officer walk into a black man's apartment and gun him down thinking it was her or saying that she thought it was hers. America is getting the message loud and clear. You can do what you want to us. This is not an accident. This is not happenstance. This is not a strange coincidence. This is America going back to what she's always been. This is America showing you what she believes.
Mm.
This is America doing exactly what it's always done. Kill people of color with no one being brought to account for it. And all you have to do is say you are afraid.
And that's crazy. He labels America as she, the daughter of Babylon.
So look, you remember the first video that we opened up with, right? DL asked the question, has America really changed since the 70s? And that's why I chose to end it on that. He's telling you, America is doing the same thing that it has always done.
Right.
That you, and showing what it has always shown, you can do whatever to the blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians and suffer no consequences.
No consequences. Yep.
So America ain't changed at all. That's why God calls it Mystery Babylon, the mother of all harlots.
Mm.
Nathaniel of Israel United in Christ. Please subscribe to our YouTube channels. Stay up to date with our latest events, music, and classroom lessons. IUIC plans to continue visiting different countries where this gospel has not been preached before. IUIC needs your help in pushing this truth. So join us, subscribe to our Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and podcast, and stay up to date with us. For more information, please visit www.israelunite.org.